Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. Please watch this video till the end. As military veterans, local officials and area residents reflected on the attack on Pearl Harbor 79 years ago Sunday afternoon during a gathering on and near the Pearl Harbor Veterans Memorial Bridge, a bell was rung 21 times as an enduring symbol of peace. Zack Willette, 9, of South Hadley, repeatedly tapped the bell held by his brother Josh, 11. "We are paying honor to the people lost," Zack said of the annual Pearl Harbor Remembrance Ceremony, timed to the December 7, 1941, attack that killed 2,400 Americans and wounded 1,100. Two of their great-grandfathers served in World War II. In addition to the bells of peace, a custom that began after World War I, the ceremony included a three-volley rifle salute and taps performed on a bugle, and the dropping of a red, white and blue wreath from the bridge into the Oxbow of the Manhan River by Easthampton Mayor Nicole LaChapelle and Northampton Mayor David Narkewicz. The wreath was escorted to them by Aaron Sparko of Easthampton Boy Scouts Troop 205. Michael Slater, Veteran Services Officer for Easthampton and South Hadley, said the attack on Pearl Harbor showed Americans' unbreakable spirit. He read excerpts from a speech made by President Roosevelt the day after the date, which will live in infamy. The local ceremony began when Pearl Harbor survivor Edward F. Barutsky of Southampton, who died at 94 in 2015, won legislative approval for getting the Route 5 bridge renamed for veterans of the attack in 2004. "We humbly dedicate this day to Ed and his fellow Pearl Harbor survivors," Slater said. Steve Connor, director of Central Hampshire Veterans Services, said he remembers when Barutsky, August Augie Wojciechowski of Northampton, and Joseph Mielesko, who lived at the soldiers' home in Holyoke, were still alive to be recognized. "They are all dear to our hearts, and that's why we come here," Connor said. Connor said he hopes people will understand that the attack and the United States' subsequent entry into World War II changed many lives, much like the September 11, 2001, attacks did. LaChapelle read a mayoral proclamation that recognizes the bravery and courage of those at Pearl Harbor. The ceremony, for the first time, was not held on the actual anniversary, but instead marks a move to the first Sunday in December every year, allowing for greater participation by working parents and schoolchildren. Brian Willette, state commander of the Military Order of the Purple Heart, said it had been 5 years since his sons had been able to be at the event because of being in school. Though the ceremony brought out more than 50 people, it was interrupted for about 20 minutes when a participant faced medical issues, prompting a response by two Easthampton ambulances and a fire truck. That's all for today. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. Thanks, see you soon with some new video.